information. And interestingly, the number of things I saw at the Turkish exhibition is not even half of what is being displayed at the exhibition in Nigeria right now. So what it means is there's a potential for the Turkish medical manufacturers and all of that in this market, you know. So I can just only encourage that we have more Turkish people. Because when you say Africa is the next big market, you can't stay in Turkey and do business in Africa. You need to come right down here and see what is happening and experience it yourself. And I'm glad that the Tech Trust team could testify to this fact and everything. So if there's anybody thinking of doing business in Nigeria, we're very glad to host you. And like Nazee said, all of these efforts, we hope that it will pay off someday very soon. Thank you very much, everybody.
You're welcome, Darren. Thank you for being there for us. I visited also Lagos in the past, and he has been great host from airport to airport. And he started doing some business through Turnkey. Also, it is beneficial for him. Mr. Nezih, are you here, Mr. Nezih? Good to see you after a long break. You just returned from Cameroon, or?
I just returned Cameroon. That's why this Saturday I wasn't on the site. Since I was on the site during the weekdays in Cameroon. But luckily, tomorrow I will hire a general manager of Indian company who is doing mining business in Cameroon. He is going to come tomorrow and visit us on Monday. Hope Cameroon will bring us luck.
How was the Cameroon trip?
It was tiring, but there is so many things to do in Cameroon, especially where we are doing site mobilization is a newly developed area. They have a big port and so on, so on. It will be booming in 10 years' time. It is somehow developed country rather than some of the other African countries. Unfortunately, I couldn't visit Ethiopia. Ethiopia is also one crucial destination.
You used the Ethiopian Airways.
Yes, yes.
It was a connected flight up from Addis Ababa.
Yes, yes. And Ethiopia is like a hub. I understand why Mr. Mariam is trying to attract in Dubai also. They have a great connection through the Ethiopia Airlines to the Dubai, not Istanbul. And even Ethiopia Airlines entered the market several years with 130 flat mean planes.
Mm-hmm. Nezih, you didn't introduce your company, Aterco.
Yes, Aterco prefabricated company. We are producing prefabricated building materials, light steel, heavy steel, and living mobile containers. We are doing business either in Turkey and outside of the Turkey. We just awarded a school project in Democratic Congo for additional schools. And we are on the way to get some school project in Senegal. Hopefully next week it will finalize either positive or negative. What we did Africa is more except OYAK project, more important for us. Now we are following almost three projects with group members. One, Mr. Ozan helped us to involve a tender in Kenya. It is going well also. We are negotiating with client. Client have is going to have fixed the timeline and budget. one project in Africa also with Mr. Ibrahim Özen, and one project with Mr. Mejid.
Nezih, you made a good point. What members should do to develop business among each other? One-on-ones are very important, right?
Yes, one-on-one is very important, and we should know capabilities, and even we should push each other to make business, because it's not easy, even in Turkey, to make business together. But doing some business in another country is very difficult. For like project wise, for material wise, standard product, it's not big issue. But if you keep on a project, I mean several undefined items, it is too hard. As you were doing hotel projects in abroad, there are too many subdivision of the materials and so on. It is hard to manage and control. That's why we should increase the B2Bs, and even we should try to increase the network by thinking as we were in the incident.
Okay, thank you very much, Mr.
For instance, last few weeks, another business group, they ask LPG tanker if anyone is producing. I just ask Mr. Kartal, and I
delivered with truck or without.
He didn't mention it at all. He didn't mention the specification. That's why I didn't involve. I just wrote to personal. If
okay, Mr. Enes, are you here?
Maybe he reach him or not. I just delivered the contact. Like okay. if we try harder, this contact deliveries even can bring business.
Yeah, we should contribute to the network, like Mr. Balkan invited Mr. Ilyas, or Mr. Tunç Vidinli brought us Mr. Enes. So it's for the benefit of everyone. For example, I was gonna say, Mr. Enes, I can introduce you to Öztrailer. As you know, Öztrailer makes LPG trucks, and I know the owner of the company through DEİK, Foreign Economic Relations Board. Okay, since everyone introduced himself, herself, we are ready for the webinar of Mr. Tunç Vidinli. Mr. Tunç Vidinli?
Mr. Rashid.
Orkan dedi. I forgot. Hi. I no missed problem. You. Okay, go ahead.
Okay, I will talk shortly. Hello, everybody. This is Orkan from Onel Customs Consultancy. We are a custom broker and consultancy company. We provide custom clearance services, and we can provide your related certificates which needs for your foreign trade. And we improve new services like CRM, foreign trade department service, foreign trade relations. This means that we can integrate with your potential buyers, abroad contacts, and we can manage your meetings, promotings, and we can contact and describe your products, how your products can be imported or exported between the abroad and Turkey. So we can create a distribution channel. Only thing you should focus is to catch the order. After order, we will make it easy for you for your foreign trade.
All the operation. Yeah.
Okay. Yes.
Thank you very much, Orkan. Anything related with import export?
Yes. Also,
operation.
Also. For example, I have green passport. Nowadays, there is a visa problem. If you need somebody to represent you on the abroad, I can go and tell your potential buyers your products and how this foreign trade will happen with custom clearance process, integrated service. Sometimes we do that, go to potential buyers or sometimes commercial trades and tell them how that product's clearance process, foreign trade process should go on between Turkey.
Okay, thank you, Orkan. We are waiting. We are waiting for your support. Also, Mr. Osman has.
Yes, by the way, I already talked with him. We are now started to studying about that. Now I am preparing the reports. I am making a brief report focused to products and company types, which would be more healthier to contact with our potential with current members of Turkey.
Thank you, Orkan. Mr. Tunçvidin, the floor is yours.
Okay. All right. Thank you very much. Thank you, Mr. Kuşkaya. Dear members, my name is Tunç Vidinli. I'm a family business consultant. I make family businesses last for many generations. That's what I do. Thank you for the opportunity to present our services to businesses, business people like yourself. It's a privilege to be here, first of all. I own a family business consultancy company under the brand Veliaht Academy. We are establishing family constitutions, aile anayasaları. We provide management consultancy, yönetim danışmanlığı, and coaching to families, Veliaht koçluğu, koçluk danışmanlıklar. We help family companies run under corporate rules of management. One of our best companies is also in the group, Mr. Enes. I also wish to thank him. Yani aile şirketlerin kurumsallaşması konumuz. This presentation will be translated to Turkish by me. Ebu Bekir ve Hüseyin Beylere de katıldığı için de teşekkür etmek istiyorum. Ayrıca müşterilerimizden Güven Bombe, Enes Bey de grupta, kendisine daha önce teşekkür etmek istiyorum. All right then, here we go. There are a number of basic studies that need to be carried out together in order for family businesses to survive for many years. Our core team consists of 5 people, although we are expanding our and currently training new academic personnel for our future expansions. Next one, please. I come from a very old industrial...
Would you like to introduce team members or next one?
Actually, I don't want to take it too long, but okay. As you can see, just a small introduction to my family, my team members. Ibrahim is here and you met him. We have 2 really accomplished people, Volkan Bey, Deniz Hanım. They have expertise on their fields over 20-25 years with the ages over 50. What we do is we do it from the heart and from the roots of the business. Onurcan is also our social media management personnel. I come from a very old industrialist family dating back to the founding of Turkish Republic, more than 100 years. I'm the 4th generation in my family. My childhood was spent in family businesses. I can say that family business issues are integrated in my DNA. This allows me to be competitive in consulting and have a deep understanding of the subject that we are working on. Currently, next one, please. This is my family, dating to 100 years of ages, as you can see, okay. Currently, I still have board memberships in our own family companies. Buraya kadar bir kısaca Türkçe anlatayım. Yaptığımız iş, ben yaptığım işin dibinden, kökünden gelen bir insanım. Yani DNA'ma işlendi bu yaptığım iş. Ve ailem 4 nesil sanayici, yaklaşık değil 100 seneden fazla oldu benim ailem sanayiye gireli. Ve yani Adanalı bir aileden geliyorum. Aile şirketlerinin ve bunların bazıları gerçekten çok ünlü şirketler. Bildiğiniz isimlerini sık sık telaffuz ettiğiniz şirketler. Bunların içinde büyüdüm açıkçası. Bu benim avantajım bu konuda. Hala da kendi aile şirketlerimiz baba tarafından, anne tarafından da var. Şirketlerin yönetim kurullarındayım. Genel kurullarına katılıyorum. Currently, I still have board memberships in our own families, I can say. Apart from the companies that we are consulting, I attend the general assembly meetings of our family companies from time to time. All right, what is a family business? What does this mean in clearer terms? The next one, can we have it, please? Family business, a business in which a management is under the control of a family is called family business. What does this mean? If the family has the power to determine the next captain of the company, that company is a family company, I can say. Can we have the next one, please? All right. In these preceding few slides, you'll see what happens to family businesses. Let's take this 100%, the 100 blue dots, blue icons on the screen as family businesses. Family businesses have difficulty in reaching the third generation. This is not very current and has no clear worldwide ratio, but the image that you see here shows general dominance, I can say. Can we have all of them? This is, and the last one goes up to, down to, let me say, three companies. After three generations.
Can yes. you say Mr. Company of Mr. NS is in this category?
He is, yes, surely is going to be in that 3%, surely. I'm going to talk about all those issues shortly. Türkçe anlatmak gerekirse bu her bir çizgiyi 100 şirket olarak alın, yüzde olarak Türkiye'nin genel dünyanın aslında yüzdesi. Üçüncü nesilden sonrasını görebilenler. Üçüncü nesli görmek mesele değildir, görürsünüz bir şekilde. Sonrasını sağlıklı bir şekilde şirketi yıkmadan görebilmek %3'ü alır. Yani o 100 şirketin çoğunun gittiğini görüyorsunuz o tabloda. O yüzden hani bu önemli bir çalışma yürüttüğümüz. All right. The solution to all the basic problems of family companies is properly managed human resources, I should say. Everything from company management starts with people. It reaches to people through people. Human resources are the basis of money and business management. Money management and also the business management. On the basis, there is human. Strong and accurate human resources move companies, I can say. Okay, next one, please. Okay, let's take a look at this human resource. There are two types of human resources in family businesses. The ones before, please. Family-based and management, these two types. Other members of the family, as you can see, there are family members who are excluded from the management coming from the family. Other members of the family run the company, the second one. They are family members and also in the management. And the third one, professional workforce. Blue collar and white collar workers in the family business. Okay, what services do we provide for these human resources? As you can see, all three human resources on the screen, and we provide different services for each family members in the family business. First one is establishing the family constitution, which is the umbrella of all the services we provide. We call it living family constitution. I'll come to that. Transition, the living family constitution requires all the members of the family company, the professional workforce and the family to present in the, to be represented in the constitution. The second one is transition to corporate governance. Birincisi üç şimdi bir aile vardır. Ailenin içerisinde işe dahil olanlar, dahil olmayanlar vardır. Bir de profesyonel yönetim vardır. Üçe ayırıyoruz bunu. Aile işte işe dahil olmayan aile, işin içerisindeki aile ve profesyonel çalışanlar olarak üçe ayırdığımız zaman yaşayan anayasa dediğimiz çalışma, Enes Beylerle yürütüp nihayetine ulaştığımız çalışma aileyi çalışanlarıyla beraber ele alır, şemsiye niteliğindedir. İkincisi, the second one is transition to corporate governance, kurumsal yönetime geçiş dediğimiz ikinci çalışma. Bu çalışmada aileden ya da aileden olmayan çalışanları dahil ederiz. The second one on the corporate governance service, we service the workers and the family members. And the third one is rain coaching, including family members, next generations. Üçüncüsü de veliaht koçluğu dediğimiz aile bireylerini, ailenin bir sonraki nesillerini yetiştirdiğimiz, geliştirdiğimiz çalışma. Okay, establishment of the living family constitution. Can we have the next one, please? Okay, what is the family constitution? There's a reason we call this constitution a living family constitution. With all these three studies we carry out, we ensure that the family constitution is functional and it keeps on living. All right, the family constitution, aile anayasası nedir? Family principles, aile prensipleri, family contract, aile kontratı, family protocol, aile protokolü de deniyor, is a plan, bir plandır. And written statement of this plan, bu planın yazılı bir beyanatı, that points out to achieve the preservation of the family's culture, heritage and success for generations. Bu yazılı planda, yani bu aile anısı dediğimiz bu yazılı planda ailenin kültürünü, mirasını, bir sonraki gelecekleri bir arada tutmak için yazılmış, aile tarafından yapılmış bir çalışma bu çalışma. Next one please. Okay. Family constitution should be prepared in open and consent cooperation. Aile anayasası bir kere açık bir bakış açısı ile bütün herkes, bütün aile tarafından hazırlanmalıdır. Consent cooperation demek istediğim yani herkesin de rızası içerisinde olması lazım. Hani ben buna inanmıyorum diyen aile bireyleriyle bu olmaz açıkçası. Aile bireylerinin büyük bir kısmının buna inanması gerekiyor. Yani atıyorum 5-6 aile bireyin içerisinde bir kişi hani ben çok sıcak değilim demesi önemli değil. O en azından 6 kişinin 5'i, at least let's say if the family consists of 6 members, at least 4 or 5 of that 6 people should be consent. And the second one is, bir öncekine dönsek. And the second one is, family constitution is the beginning of a process, not the end. Its implementation should be part of the family mission. Aile anayasası aynı zamanda bir prosesin başlangıcıdır, sonu değil. Ve ailenin misyonunun bir parçası olmalıdır. Okay, the second one is transition to corporate governance. In corporate management, there should be first a leader and then a management system. Next one, please. Okay. And thus, we work on leadership for leaders and establishing the management system for the corporate management system. Şimdi aile kurumsal yönetime geçişte iki bacak var. Lider ve yönetim sistemi. Biz şirketlerde bir liderlik için çalışırız. İkinci çalışmada yani kurumsal yönetime geçiş dediğimiz diğer çalışmada liderlik için çalışırız. Ve bir kurumsal yönetim sisteminin kurulması için çalışırız. Anlattığım çalışmaların hiçbiri birbirinden ayrılmaz. These services I'm talking about is not separable. They should be all together. And our third study, teşekkürler bir sonraki. And our third study, we develop the next generations of the family. Üçüncü çalışmamızda da ailenin bir sonraki nesillerinin yetiştirilmesi için çalışırız. Gençler işin içerisinde olur. Veliaht koçluğu. This is air coaching and we coach the next generations of the family. Can we have the next one, please? Okay. What is an air coach? Veliaht koçu nedir? Is being the elder brother, sister to the bosses of the future.
It's like Prince Charles becoming king today.
Yes.
After waiting how many years?
For many years.
I think 70 years. We forgot, Azrail forgot taking the life of king of, queen of England.
That's true. And Elizabeth. Also, I should also, the one before, please. I should point out that Ottoman, Osmanlı Sultans, Osmanlı Padişahları, kings and queens of European empires, imparatorlukların kraliçeleri, kraliçeleri filan. Yani hep bunlar yetiştiriliyor. These people are, they are always coached. They have been coaching for many years. Bu zaten yıllardır onlarda olan sistemler. What I do is I do it in the tradition of the Turkish culture. Ben bunu Türk kültürünün içerisinde yapıyorum. Yani veliaht koçluğu, geleceğin patronlarına abilik, ablalık diyoruz biz buna. Okay, can we have the next one, please? Okay, air coaching focuses on first, leadership. Second, preparing the heirs, this is the one before, preparing the heirs for the institution, corporatization, and third one, family ties and relationships. Üç noktaya odaklanıyoruz biz veliaht koçluğunda. Liderlik, gene hani kurumsal yönetime geçişteki gibi. Liderlik, yani o gençlerin lider olmaları. İkinci olarak şirketin kurumsal yönetime geçişinin onlara anlatılması. Üçüncü olarak da aile ilişkileri ve aile bağları. Bakın, burada önemli olan bir şey var. There is an important thing in here. The next generations of the families should be prepared for the constitutionalization, because after they learn what should be done, they will be the one that will take the company, they will make this transition, they will perform this paradigm shift for the company. Burada önemli olan şu veliaht koçluğunda, ailelerin birinci nesillerini, yani büyük nesillerin diyeyim, öndeki büyük nesillerin kurumsal yönetime geçişte zorlandıklarını görüyoruz. Biz o yüzden yani mesela ben gençliğin ilk bu işleri yaptığım yıllardan beri böyle babayı gördüğüm zaman rica ederdim, oğlumuzla çalışabilir miyim diye. Çünkü biliyorum, yani o anne baba, genelde babalar var tabii ki Türkiye'de aile şirketlerinde yönetici. O babalar biliyorum, yani işlerin içerisine girmeyecekler, değişmeyecekler, bir şeyleri daha iyi noktaya gitmek için çok fazla hareket etmeyecek. Ya bana karışma diyor. Ben de bunu bildiğim için baştan söyledim. Sizinle değil de işte kızınızla, oğlunuzla çalışsam derdim ki kabul ederlerdi. Ki bu işin doğrusu yıllarda bunu bana gösterdi açıkçası. What I do in air coaching, I have seen this many times in family businesses, that the elders of the family, they don't want to transition to corporate management. So I do it with their kids, with their daughters and with their sons. The service is like a professional working family member, I can say. Yani bu profesyonel bir, şöyle düşünün, yani bir aile büyüğümüz var ama bu bir profesyoneldir. That kind of a service this one is. And all these three things I have mentioned, üç bu bahsettiğim şeyin, yani belirli aşamalarında şirketin yapılması gerekiyor o kurumsal yönetimin gerçekleşmesi için. Anayasanın hazırlanması, kurumsal yönetime geçişin düzenlenmesi lideriyle, kurumsal yönetim sistemiyle. Üçüncü olarak da bir sonraki nesillerin bu çalışmanın içerisinde yetiştirilmesi. All these three services should be provided all together in one inseparable package in order for the company to move to that transition, in order for that paradigm shift to occur. Okay, this is generally what I do, and I would like to answer your questions from now on. Teşekkür ediyorum beni dinlediğiniz için. Sorularınız varsa cevaplamak isterim açıkçası. Çok teşekkür ediyorum. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mr. Vidilli, for the detailed presentation. I have a question. What was the hardest case you handled so far?
Generally, the hardest cases are the ones that the family is not willing to do this. They only heard it from someone, told that this is what should be done. I recommend you to do this, and they start working with us.
They don't believe, but they want to give it a try.
Yes, they want to give it, not just give it a try. They don't want to give it a try. they just heard it and they know it's something cool that should be done in a family business. Let's do it, let's try it. I know that it's not gonna work. That's the hardest case. Bu işte en zor olan nokta ailenin gerçekten niyetli olması. Bunun havalı bir çalışma olarak görülmesi. İşte birinden tavsiye alması. Ya bunu yap, fayda sağlıyor. Ya işe yaramaz ama hadi bir yapmış olalım demesi benim için yani en zor durum. Generally we don't work those kind of companies. Genelde o tarz şirketlerle çalışmıyoruz. Ve sistemimiz de yani bizim genel pazarlama yönetim sistemimiz ki buna İbrahim de şahittir. Buna niyetli olan insanları bizimle çalışmaya ikna etmek, o insanları toplamakla ilgili.
With Mr. Enes Kartal, GBS, you are it in which stage now?
We have completed the constitution. Right now, we are working on the second one, transition to corporate management. Their heirs are too young to involve in the process. But in any way, I have also made them a speech. We have talked with them. I told them what is going to be. And maybe in time, I will be talking with them also.
There's a potential customer for you also here, Ecosklinker. There is a family company. Mr. Gökhan can introduce you with the second generation, Mr. Emre. I think they need also your consultancy. It's, they have two factories in Bilecik. Am I right,
Gökhan? We have one factory in Bilecik, Bozüyük, and we are taking that type's lessons from one company.
Ah, you are taking already a consultant.
Who are you working with? If, may I ask you?
Sorry? Do you know name of the consultant?
Valla Türkçesini söyleyeyim bunun. Hani benim açımdan bu tarz konuşmaları İngilizce yapmak zor geliyor. Kolaya kaçmayı seviyorum bazı noktalarda. Atakoç Eğitim Danışmanlık firmasından bu hizmeti alıyoruz. Osman Can Özen'dir. Ben de çeşitli iletişim konularında kendisinden destek alıyorum.
Bey, aslında siz firma adını Ata Bey olarak değiştirseniz daha iyi olur bence. Şehzade Koçluğu gibi.
Veliaht Akademi oradan geliyor aslında firma. Yani daha evet. Bizim markam, yani firma adı değil ama markamızın adı. Markamız evet. Bizim.
Aslında Osmanlı tesadüfen Osmanlı olmamış değil mi? Yani başarısının sırrı Koçluk'ta mı diyorsun?
Kesinlikle Osmanlı tesadüfen Osmanlı olmuyor. Yani ilk başlarda güçlü bir aile var. En başta işte Osman Bey, Orhan Bey zamanlarında fetheden, savaşan, işte bir ekibi arkasında toplayan, işte orduyu arkasında toplayan ama daha sonra imparatorluk haline gelen devlet-i âliye Osmaniye olmasındaki arkasındaki zaten sistem bu. Kaldı ki onlara da gelen Atabeylik sistemleri var. Selçuklulardan da onlara gelmiş. Yani bunlar böyle sürekli giden, gelişen.
Bin yıllık bir kültür ya.
Evet çok gerçekten eski ve derin bir kültür. Tabii biz de çalışmalarımızda bunu göz önünde bulundurmak zorundayız. Yani şöyle bir şey söz konusu açıkçası. Yani ben bu işi gerçekten çocukluğumdan beri yapıyorum. Yani yani söz meclisten dışarı yani ne yaptığını bilmeyen insanlarla dolu. Şimdi mesela burada siz herkesi almıyorsunuz bu platforma. Buraya herkes giremiyor. Çünkü herkes ben ihracattan anlarım deyip yapamıyor bu işleri. Yani beceremiyor. Aynı şey söz konusu. Bizim yaptığımız işte de yani yanlış insan yarar sağlamanın ötesinde zarar sağladığı sizler tanıyorsunuz o isimleri. Zaten söylememe gerek yok. Bunların örnekleri çok...
Yani iyi bir şirketi de hasta ediyor değil mi? İyi giden.
Evet iyi bir şirketi hasta ediyor. Eğer Gökhan Bey gerçekten o şirketin faydasını görüyorsanız size tavsiyem o şirketle yani ömür boyu bırakmayın. Bunu size tavsiye edeyim. Faydasını böyle gün be gün yani gün göremezsiniz de böyle dönüp bakın böyle 3 ay 5 ay içerisinde 6 ay 1 sene bunları yapmışız diyorsanız da...
Tunç Bey hemen bir araya gireyim. Bu Yakaza Metal'in sahibi Deniz Bey de bu tür bir danışmanlık arıyordu. Birlikte gidelim olur mu? Ben size kontak detayını vereyim. Deniz Sardoğan'ı. Siz randevu alın birlikte gidelim randevuyu yaptığınızda.
Tabii ki. Seve seve.
Tina Hanım doğru mu?
Evet,
Deniz Bey, bana birkaç defa ben kurumsallaşmak istiyorum. Bütün yük benim omzumda çok zorlanıyorum, götüremiyorum diye. Dert yanmıştı. Onun da ihtiyacı var diye tahmin ediyorum. Okay. Anybody has question for Mr. Tunç? Mr. Muaz?
Thank you very much. I like this topic a lot. I wanted to ask about the second generation in general. Do you prefer that the second generation, if they are not ready, if they are new or like raw material, do you prefer that they should do this type of business, the family business outside of the company, and then they will join the family company?
Very good question, Hassan.
Or right away they can work in the family company from zero and be very clear in their evaluation.
Thank you. That question is a fundamental one. I get all the time. Of course, I recommend that the young member of the family should work outside the company in the first years. Actually, this doesn't mean that those generations will be working in the company in any time of their life. They might never come to the company. That is also an alternative, a healthy one. The real thing is that member should be strong enough to be one day to be the member of the board, to choose the general manager of the company. But sometimes on companies we see members that started working in the company. It's very wrong to say that to dictate him to leave the company and work outside. It's very wrong. Sometimes the members prefer upon our consultancy, they ask their members to work outside. We also help those members working outside the company in the while we are implementing these services to them. This depends on the situation, but I don't recommend that always a member should be in the company, but the member should be strong enough to be in the board of the company and choose the general manager.
So I think it was a short answer. But yeah, as it is better for the second generation to work outside and then come back to the company, not start off as a high-level manager, Mr. Maaz. Thank you very much, Tunç Vidinli.
It's been
more than 2 hours now since our session started. People are getting bored. I can understand from the faces. It's time to say goodbye. If anybody doesn't have anything to say, closing remarks, I wish everyone happy weekend. Hope to see you guys all next Saturday.
Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you for listening.
Have a nice weekend.
İyi haftalar.
İyi haftalar.